Well, that's it's so interesting though. Look, these creatures are just territorial. They actually weren't attacking me willingly, unless they were just
wind's
actual
picking up again.
Attacks, like incoming attacks. These guys are in the wild. They're neutral. Fuck.
Wait, I do.
I'm sure you don't even do that much damage.
Oh, he does so much damage!
okay. Just have to recuperate our losses. Gotta rebuild what we've lost. And then we'll be fine. Just gotta bolster our defenses next time. Gonna have to definitely put a lot of our research into turrets this time. I think that is definitely the play. Didn't they also say that there was a hive or some type of den attacking us as well? Or a nest? Wherever the creatures are originating from. The Canotropix. Because I gotta get rid of that as well. They're gonna be much of a nuisance. Very, very big nuisance. Okay, I should work on headquarters first, actually. Don't want to lose or die. That would be bad. You know what? I'm just gonna double the walls.
Hostile creatures are coming from a nearby nest. You should go there and clear it out.
Yeah, nearby nest. Yeah. I need to know where they're attacking first, though. And then I'll start heading out. I also need to focus on putting down mines as well. Keep that checked.
Base is under attack.
Okay, so they're coming from down there.
The air is getting dense. A fog is forming up.
Wall destroyed.
Oh, come on. I think I rebuilt those walls.
It's hard to see anything in this fog.
Oh my gosh, this fog is evil. Wait, so are there two dens? Oh.
Aronium storage is full. Build more storage facilities.
Aha!
Walls has been destroyed.
Base
you cannot best
attack
me in combat, you primitives. You are no match for me. Kneel. Wait, so there are definitely, yeah, there's definitely two hives. So the other one came from the bottom left, the other one's from middle left of the base.
Warning, hostile creatures are coming from a nearby nest. We should go there and clear it out.
Nearby nest, nearby, where, the map, this is map. A nearby nest, I'm assuming, gotta, down here actually, yeah. Okay, that's good, they marked it on the map, so. It's just it blended in with a giant creature. Wow, there's a lot of these guys. They don't run out, do they?
Base is under attack.
Yeah, how did they get through, really? Okay, so the fog's cleared up, so we'll be good for now.
The fog is gone. Base efficiency is back to normal.
Oh wait, I think I think they were just attacking it. Like those shots that just trailed out, trailed past me. They probably just hit the walls. Yeah, I gotta go clear this out now. I hope that's down there. I hope. Cause if it's not, dealing with another attack is gonna be very painful. Ooh.
Warning! Hostile creatures are coming from a nearby nest. You should go there and clear it out.
Okay, I'm assuming those warnings are just one nest, not like 10 other nests. Or is- Oh my gosh! Oh wait! Oh, I had heals, really? How did I not get this? Oh, that's pretty here. Actually, I don't want to destroy this area. I'll leave this preserved for studies, of course. Because I am robot, and robot have no feelings. Alright, all cleared. Now what is this giant creature, you say? Whoa!
This creature is extremely hostile. It can be dangerous to our base.
Kill it before it kills us. We'll finish researching it in the lab.
Oh, mucks! Bunch of mucks.
Carbonium storage is full. We should construct more
storage.
Oh,
it's like a scantipede. Also from StarCraft. But it's huge. Ah, you think you can best me in combat? Some danger. Can't even handle a lone mech warrior. Ooh, oh my gosh. Yo, why is that spot getting pinged though? Is that just to kill the aggressive creature? Okay. Well, I guess this is the biggest monster we've seen so far compared to the other ones that are still big. I'm sure you don't even do that much damage. Oh, he does so much damage! Oh, God, that hurts. Come on, you're almost dead. Okay, yeah, just play safe. We don't need to adventure. Don't need to adventure that much.
Threat neutralized.
I wonder what made it so aggressive. Maybe we can learn something important after researching it in a lab.
What made it so aggressive? What made everything on this planet so aggressive? You should be asking that. Research everything but that. Research everything and that. But now that that's clear, that's not the nest though. Where is the nest? This may also be useful. It's only 25 carbonium. They definitely wanted us to just use this. Definitely should put it right next to it. I wrote this. The important areas actually. Can you only have two? No. Creates a rift in space and allowing me to travel to its location. No, it could be anywhere. Okay, so that's helpful. So I'll put it right. I'll have three, one on the top left, bottom, well, it's not really bottom, the top left, next to the headquarters, and then bottom right. So I guess four.
Too close to another portal.
Oh, that's a portal. Okay, that makes sense. So there's only one there, gotta put one down here. There we go. Ergo.
The wind is picking up speed. Loose objects are starting to fly.
Oh, really? Wow. It's insane speed. Okay, so the armory, probably not close to the wall, because that seems to be the first thing that gets taken out.
Wind turbine efficiency is at maximum.
I'll probably remove this as well. Doesn't seem like we're... No, this area isn't really... in danger, I would say. So definitely you should put all the important infrastructure in here, like the armory. Then this is the orbital scanner. Yes. Okay. So I need to check. I haven't actually seen what's in here. Sludge. Great. Oh, this is okay. That's interesting. So it is just one mission. And then we head all over the map. It'd be nice if we had an ocean mission too, when we're just building underwater. Sure, that's possible. Geothermal vents. Definitely need to research into that as well for some continuous amount of energy. Rocket launch. Oh, I forgot we researched this one. Gotta wait for that. It wasn't even building. My bad. Rift station. Okay, gotta rebuild this one. Need to rebuild this one. But I'll put it next to our infrastructure. Our big infrastructure. Yes, right here. Okay, I will be a bit. I'll be back. I'm gonna be trying to make the walls double.
The wind is calming down. Wind turbine power output is coming back to normal.
Yeah, I'm gonna try doubling the walls in our defense. It's gonna try researching some extra turrets as well, so I'll be back.
Thank you.
Alright, now that the base is finally complete, we finally have double walls all around, as you can see, so nothing is getting through here at all, nothing at all.
Carbonium deposit.
And you see these turrets, these lights also protruding next to the...
A large group of creatures is gathering.
Let me finish!
Attack.
And we can deal with the attack, they can wait. But we have turrets next to the gates, as well as lights. So you can see where the lights are at in case you get lost, you know. So you gotta find your way home somehow. And we have plenty of wind turbines on the top sector of our base.
Build more storage facilities.
We even have rift portals that I still don't know how to use. Oh, I didn't mean to, I'm sorry. Still don't know how to use those, but we'll get back to that. But you can see all of these turrets protruding along the corners as well of the walls, with plenty of power conduits to make sure they're powered, of course. And if any one of them gets disconnected, they'll still be powered regardless, because there's a lot of power conduits. Turrets guarding every single side. We also got the upgrade as well, the level 2 turret upgrade. Though I am definitely not going to use that yet, since that also costs cobalts, which we only recently found and haven't found any so far. We also have plenty of mines guarding the perimeter, and still some yet to be set up on the bottom, left, and top sectors. And of course, as you can see, all of these AI cores that are sapping away at my energy. So many AI cores.
Enemy creatures are close.
Yes, we know.
Fight.
And we remade the rift station here, as well as added a couple more energy storages. We even made a level 2 communication hub so we could download two things at once. And it's fine. Well, watch. I don't even have to go down there, and they'll clear it anyway. That's how you know I trust my defenses. They're just that good. And on the top side, that is yet to be connected with walls or guarded with walls. Excuse me.
There is a breach.
We have
walls.
A geothermal power plant, which is great, and also tracks or it excretes mud. I don't know if I used this pipeline correctly, but I hope I did. Like, if the mud is supposed to somehow, like, come out, like, you can visually see the mud, then I probably did this wrong. It probably needs to be connected to something, but it looks like it's working so far, right? It should be, at least. You see that on the bottom right? There's no more enemies. See? Now life has become much easier. Let's not get ahead of ourselves from that. Hold on.
One of our energy connectors has been destroyed.
Okay. Maybe we needed a little more defenses. Though. Yeah, I gotta learn how to use those rift station or those rift portals. It's not working so well. It's understandable that this place would break. There's plenty of these guys and only like a few turrets. This rocket launcher upgrade I also got is pretty damn good. It's like a photon cannon, but much better. Well, the other one is of course unlimited ammo. But dang, I really... That rocket launcher, man, it's too good. And the current thing I'm researching right now, as you can see, is the repair towers, because I'm kind of getting sick and tired of having to go back here over and over. I also got an ammo tower because turrets run out of ammo, apparently. And we might as well just construct these right now. They'll do their job, but the energy consumption might be a bit of a problem. I think this uses... Nah, actually not. It's only one... -1 energy upkeep.
I'm detecting a change in wind power.
Just uses some AI cores. Wind turbines. So I gotta... I wonder if they stack. Automated drones. I doubt they stack, but that would be pretty neat if they do. Oh wait, no, this uses cobalt. That's why it's so cheap on energy. Okay, but we probably don't need that for now, but now we can make the alien research
Iranian
laboratory.
Storage is full. Build more storage facilities.
Yes, yes, we will. We will. Just hold your horse. Is research right next to here? Of course. Oh, it also takes water? Okay. Ah, this will be next. So apparently the gas lines or the pipelines.
We should construct more storage buildings.
To make water, you gotta convert it to. Convert mud into water. And I forgot where the mud was. It should be pretty close though. Yeah, it might be these little brown icons right here. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So let me see how this works. Liquid pump. Obviously, we need to do that. Pumps cannot operate too close to each other. Okay. Water filtering plant purifies contaminated fluids like mud and produces clean water. So mud go there. And then water come
the
out.
The wind is coming back. Wind power is returning to normal.
So it says to it's recommended to build the thing. The laboratory next to mud. So it's easy. Because water. Yeah, we might as well just put it here. It should be all right. So the water filtering plant should be there. As well as the laboratory. Yeah, turn around right there. And then we'll connect the pipelines to the water filtering. And then we should be getting some water.
I can't wait for it to be built. This building is going to open up a whole new range of possibilities for us. If I had a base like that on Orion, I wouldn't have lost my arm back then.
How did that happen?
What's your arm?
I got careless while searching for Anorix crystals. I found a fascinating growth anomaly that was transforming all of its surroundings. I've never seen anything like that, so I had to take a sample. I was shielded inside a recon suit, but when I grabbed the crystal with my hand, it just went through it. My entire arm was infected.
Why didn't you use a bioscanner to take the sample?
They only work in conjunction with a lab like this. I didn't have a base on Orion or a mech suit to build one.
I am sorry to hear that, Ashley. And I am glad that we got paired together. I will not allow something like that to happen to you.
Aww.
Okay, let's not get too emotional about that. If you look at it from a different perspective, I got an enhanced biomechanical arm replacement and I still got the sample.
That's true. You get a cool arm. Now, the only unfortunate thing about this pipeline is that you can't even connect it through the walls. Which, I don't know why. Can't you just, like, build under the dirt?
Carbonium deposit depleted.
I don't know. I wish you could just do that. Oh, well. That's fine. Ah, now they can just break through it. That's not good. I gotta probably make this a little bit more secure now that can't really they can just break go through here. Like what? How do you Well, all that's left to do is wait for this alien research laboratory. Then we should be good. I mean I might as well just connect some of the mud pipeline from the geothermal back to here, right? Get some extra water out of that as well. Yeah, nonetheless, here we go. Connecting the pipeline to the mud pump.
Alien research laboratory construction finished. We have to supply it with clean water to keep it operational. You can produce clean water by placing a pump in any type of liquid and delivering it to a water filtering plant for processing. Connect the output from the water filtering plant to the alien research laboratory using pipes.
Finally, The alien research lab is operational. We can start gathering research samples and scanning the local flora and fauna. We can use the bioscanner to begin collecting samples without destroying the environment.
What?
It's the safest and most efficient way to advance our research.
Nah.
This is so exciting. We can finally start working on the thing that we came here to do.
Ashley, don't forget that our primary objective is to establish a two-way portal back to Earth to enable human colonization of Galatea 37.
That's true, but we also have to study this planet to ensure that it is safe for colonization and to minimize the damage done to the local ecosystem by future colonists.
Minimizing damage to the local ecosystem is listed at the end of the official list of priorities of this mission.
I'm the only human on this planet. I can set my own list of priorities.
Oh, he told you.
The planetary geomapping procedure is in progress. Calculating coordinates for possible rift jump locations. The process will soon be completed.
Okay.
Orbital scanner geomapping procedure finished. We have gathered a lot of very useful information about the planet and found traces of rare elements in multiple locations around the globe. One of Galatea's continents appears to be a barren desert that has been scorched by intense radiation and very intense solar activity. These harsh conditions are most probably caused by the high condensation of radioactive elements like uranium or thorium. Our scans have located a safe rift jump location for an initial scouting mission.
Gaining access to uranium would allow us to construct nuclear power plants and some heavy weaponry.
Whoa.
This should make surviving on Galatea much easier.
Okay.
The second interesting area is densely covered by acidic clouds of unknown origin. Spectral analysis detected traces of palladium scattered throughout this geographical zone. I have marked a safe rift jump location for initial reconnaissance on the orbital scanner interface. Titanium has been detected in a large zone of intense volcanic activity. The orbital scanner has been providing some strange readings from this area.
Temperatures ranging
from 800 to 100 Kelvin. On top of that, it is entirely impossible to get any sensible magnetic field readings from this area. We were able to find a safe rift jump location within the volcanic zone. However, you should expect extreme environmental conditions.
All of these locations contain extreme environmental hazards and unknown species of creatures. We should upgrade our equipment as much as we can before venturing out into these new biomes.
Okay. Nice. Hey, we can unlock new areas now. Let's go. Oh, it's so interesting though. Look, these creatures are just territorial. They actually weren't attacking me willingly, unless they were just
Wind's
actual.
Picking up again.
Attacks, like incoming attacks. These guys are in the wild. They're neutral.
Wait! I did what?
You? They attacked you, not me. Come on, you fools! You think just because I'm dip? What's wrong with you creatures? What is wrong with you, Hammerosaurus? Look what you've done! You made me kill innocent creatures. That's pretty cool though. Canopatrix. Oh, what did the other ones say? Those weird small scantipedes. I didn't get to see it in time.
Carbonium storage is full. Build more storage facilities.
Okay, these mud creatures are called Hedroners. Hedroners. Some lore. Lore. Oh! Egg! Hey! Yo, can you guys screw off, please? Like, I didn't do anything to you guys, and you're just being a nuisance right now. I'm trying to be mean or anything, but you guys are being a nuisance.
Oh, it's another one of these guys!
It's a Crocoon. Crocoon. This is definitely its egg. I need it. Yeah. Because it only becomes hostile as soon as I harvest this thing. Whoa, whoa, no, 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 don't let me harvest. Oh my god. Oh, this is in there. What, they just came out of nowhere. They're like, guys, he's harvesting. Get him! Get him! Like, bro, relax. And then I gotta build this little barricade here. They just know it's not a coincidence anymore. Yo, I know you guys are okay. Wait, but what if? Oh yeah, okay. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to stare for so long. Wait, I want to see what the turrets can do against one of these guys. Oh, they do pretty well. Just of course you need a few. Can't just have one sentinel turret. That's then it's just OP. Oh, wait, is it? Are they attacking the Ironiums? I just need that to be mined down. I could care less about that area. Alright. Finally. That's cool. You could jump to distant look. I want to check this out. Let's check this out. This one. Oh, but I think I have to open the rift first. Yeah, that's. And here's the lore over here. Actually, quite a few species we haven't found yet. I thought it'd be. Yeah, actually, never mind. What is it called? Yeah, so we gotta work on the rift station first. I forgot what that. This building intakes. It intakes water. Yeah, it did. It's either frozen water or water, and it intakes plasma, which we have yet to research first. But we'll probably get into that in the next episode. Yeah, this episode was mostly just trying to get this place back together. Everything was under attack. Everything was just breaking through. The double walls were definitely good. I mean, I should have seen that coming. That's the optimal build, as some people would say. The same thing as in They Are Billions or in RimWorld. It's every game. You just gotta double everything and you'll be safe. But the only problem was that we were running out of turrets and we needed turrets. That was the problem as well. And I gotta learn how to do the rift station for next time. Or the rift portal for next time. Okay. But anyways, we've solidified a location. Finally! And now, I will see you guys in the next episode. Ciao.
Affected by the plague, and I know it's pretty vague, but I saw it from my dreams. I think it's called a cactuar.
Raptor?
Cactuar.
Guitar?
Cactuar.
Akbar!
It's a freaking cactuar.
Oh, guess we gotta finish this rhyme, or we're actually gonna die, so we send it to this time to save us from our crimes, and they tell us to like, share, and subscribe. That's all good.